Well, Wednesday. One day closer to the weekend again. Yep, so yesterday, update on Ethan. Brought him up. I didn't. His mother brought him up to the walk-in just to, you know, make sure that that pain in his side, nausea wasn't, you know, appendix screwing up or something. They come home, and Ethan comes downstairs to talk to me. And I had already known what happened at the walk-in with the doctor. But, he comes down, I'm like, all right, so how you doing? Before he even tells me what he's doing, he's like, that doctor pissed me off. I'm like, what are you talking about, boy? Apparently this doctor is just an older, power trippy, or thinks a little too much of himself. But yeah, he yelled at Ethan and his mother about what they're even doing there. Little pain in the side, didn't even try taking Tylenol. Apparently a little aggressive, too. Not a doctor we'd seen there before. Did you just tell him we just want to be on the safe side? She's like, I didn't. I could barely even get words out because I was so shocked. Like, what in the fuck is wrong with you? But yeah, Ethan did not take any medication. Didn't tell anybody that he didn't take any, and we just found out about it yesterday, that it had been going on for 4 days. Man, I should have brought him. That would have been fun. I'm like, well, let me list off the reasons for you. Until you change your fucking tone. Kid here. Kids aren't the greatest with relaying information. I pay $200 a fucking week for medical insurance. Now, granted, you could say that one of the reasons I pay $200 a week is because everybody uses their medical insurance a lot, but yeah. I'm using that shit with the kids. The kids got pains, don't know what's going on. Especially when they come to me saying that something's not right. They think they need to go to the doctor. Taking their ass to the doctor. I didn't go to school and residency and everything and spent 8 years of my life training to be a freaking doctor. In all honesty, when we were talking about it before I left work yesterday, I had the location of the appendix wrong. Go figure. Gallbladder? I don't know what I'm expecting from this. Maybe for you to do your fucking job? Tell me nothing's wrong with them. Fine. Be a dick about it. Actually, it's probably for the best that I wasn't the one that brought him. Yeah. Now, I had it the one time where he was having upper chest pain. And I brought him after he had had it for like 2 days, you know, to kind of go away and come back. And I got freaking hammered for it. not really hammered, but there was some little snide comments about why did I bring him to a walk-in then if he's having chest pain. Because it's not like he's having a fucking heart attack. He had indigestion, or not indigestion, acid reflux. It's kind of what I thought it might be, but because his mom has it. But yeah, so maybe I pulled the trigger a little quicker this time. Bedside manners lacking. I almost called up Aurora to talk to him, but there was no way I was going to be able to talk to him. Now, granted, it could have been that he was busy. Maybe getting frustrated. They have a frustrating day or something, but if you can't be civil and helpful as a doctor because you get frustrated, especially if somebody who's been doing it that fucking long, you know what? Then maybe you got into the wrong line of fucking work. Your job is to deal with people. I don't know. Maybe you thought he'd be a research doctor or some shit. You don't have to deal with people. Then again, he was older. Maybe he was just pissed off that he had to pull duty in the freaking walk-in. Same time, unless they called him in from the hospital, you're still working the walk-in and stuff. Not like you're one of them hotshot hospital doctors. Yep. Especially when someone brings their kid in. Like, I've caught crap before when I finally went into the walk-in. Like, with my shoulder, like, when it started bothering you. Or the chunk of metal I still have in my shoulder, I just catch crap for that every time I go, what's this? I got a chunk of metal on my shoulder. When'd you get it removed? I didn't. It's just a small chunk that got under the skin and freaking formed over, so I got a big scar tissue ball on my shoulder. Why didn't you go? We could have done this and that. I mean, because at the time I was working 12-hour fucking days, 6 days a week. I just didn't have time. It wasn't bothering me. It healed over. I wasn't dying, so I didn't go. I should get that taken care of one of these days. I did have the doctor when he went and looked when we thought I tore my rotator. Mentioned it. And gave me a referral to a basically a surgeon to remove it. I'm like, oh man, that's a specialist. It's not going to be covered. But I was also thinking about doing it because I wanted to get more tattoo work done. So I need that taken care of and healed back up. Oh well, I'm at work. Fun day. 9 minutes. Oh crap. You get a prize for listening to me ramble. Be good. Bye.